Is America in trouble? And if so, what can we do about it?
We hit the streets and asked people their opinion, and here's what you had to say.
I think we're going downhill.
I think it's very poor.
The economy, crime seems to be getting worse in places.
We are being attacked from outside because we haven't solved our problems on the inside.
The spiritual battle in America is getting worse, and sin is running rampant.
Our nation is in very serious trouble.
And I've watched a revolution of the wrong kind in the country that I love. Are we in trouble when 65% of the people in America do not believe their moral absolutes?
I believe that we are in spiritual turmoil, and I believe that everything else that we're facing societally, culturally, is as a result of the spiritual bankruptcy.
I see the family coming apart, and our nation is only as strong as the family is.
The consensus was overwhelming. Most Americans feel our nation is in trouble. The economy continues to struggle along without any real sense of improvement. Morally, we seem to be bankrupt. Crime is rampant, including drug use, which seems to have found its way into every corner of American society. Once our core, the family, has become redefined, with now over half of American children living in fatherless homes. Divorce rates continue to rise, and marriage being redefined. 15% of Americans are now living in poverty. This is the highest rate since the Great Depression. The church seems to have lost its influence as well, as 80 to 90% of American churches are now plateaued in their attendance.
Perhaps the problem is not as insurmountable as it seems. The people we interviewed offered some thoughtful solutions and some humorous perspectives on the nation's crisis.
What will give us more peace?
Honestly, I think more marijuana.
I guess we gotta elect the right people, I guess.
America's coming around, man. Cool is coming back.
Fundamentally, the spirit needs to be free.
The focus that I think we must have is what's happening to his church. Unfortunately, I see the church of Jesus Christ in this nation separating itself from its biblical foundations and from the teachings of Christ, the expectations of Christ.
We're losing the foundation of God in America.
So what's our answer?
I think it's Jesus Christ and Him alone. And it's in Him the power of salvation comes for America and for the world.
In other words, there's no hope apart from revival.
While I want godly people in the White House, it's not going to happen in the White House. It's going to happen in the church house.
But can the church, as citizens of faith across America, really change a nation?
Church leaders say that we can, and we must, bring real solutions to America's problems. And here's what some of them have to say.
I put the conditions of this nation and this society not at the feet of one political party or another, but at the feet of the church.
There's a real parallel to the early 1800s before the Second Great Awakening. And it was in that time of crisis that this country got desperate for God.
We pray for our lost loved ones. That's important, but we ought to start by praying that God would cleanse our own lives and keep us transparent before Him so that He could fill us with His Spirit and use us. That's what the church can do.
I repent of my sin. I think not only repent of my own personal sin, but own the sin of my country and my nation.
If we're not praying, if we're not asking God to move and to work, you know, it's just our work is going to be in vain.
Seeking God and loving people.
We have a role to restore, to reconcile, to bring peace where there's brokenness.
But we need to get out of our comfortable pews and our comfortable settings and reach out to people in a new way.
I think pastors have the responsibility of speaking to the culture in which we find ourselves.
We need to act, not react. Typically what we do in the church is we react to things. We see moral and ethical issues and we react to them rather than being proactive.
As we interact with the people and their worldviews, we want to be aware that they're going to have different perspectives than we do, and we want to interact with them wisely and patiently.
And I think we need to be observant and see what's happening and see our young people where they're headed and see what's happening in our culture. And then we need to move out there as a vast army of the Lord and touch these lives, correct these possibly by the grace of the Lord, touch lives.
One of my professors said, read your Bible in one hand and the newspaper in the other and find out how to apply the scripture to what's going on in the day.
I think the church continues to impact the culture by living out our lives for Christ and showing the love of Christ to other people.
At the University of Mobile Center for Leadership, we want to do our part to help restore the nation. Every day, we provide informative communications and credible resources to help you bring proactive solutions to our nation's crisis.
We have a team working full-time every day, trying to bring these solutions to America's problems. Together, we can and we must restore our nation in crisis.
For more information, visit our website at umcenterforleadership.org.